Good morning, everyone. My name is Deng Xi, and I am a graduate student at College of Computer, National University of Defense Technology in China. It's my great pleasure to be here today to share my research with you. My topic is a modular hierarchical model for paper quality evaluation. Next, I will make my report from five aspects: introduction, related work, methodology, experiments and results, and conclusions. The first part is introduction. As thousands of papers appear, evaluating their quality helps to select high-quality papers from them quickly. Naturally, this task can help readers choose good papers rapidly, assist reviewers in reviewing papers, and allow authors to self-check their papers. However, the research on this level task still has a long way to go. As we follow major's innovativeness and contribution, accuracy is a key to evaluating the paper's quality. To the best of our knowledge, there is no public available expert-rated large-scale dataset on the innovativeness and the contributions of papers in the field. More importantly, the models need to be pre-trained with sufficiently large real-world data of mathematical, computer, and other types of subject expertise. Even the state-of-the-art models have less rich prior knowledge about the paper than the reviewers. Therefore, models' law can hardly truly understand and evaluate the innovation and the contribution of a paper from its text alone. We leave it to future researchers to fully understand the innovativeness and the contributions of papers. However, the experiment's results in this paper demonstrate that our model works well in evaluating the quality of papers. That is, the model has an excellent ability to evaluate papers after training. In reality, the quality of a paper is tough to measure accurately with specific values. Thus, most work will take the paper's acceptance as a proxy for quality evaluation. Since the conference at a different level and the domain have different quality standards for papers, researchers will carry out their work on a specific level conference dataset in a particular field, where they will directly use a specific conference as a dataset to unify the quality standards of the model. Following the convention, we conduct our experiments on the SALR conference dataset produced ourselves. But in theory, our model will also be able to find papers that meet this quality standard after being trained on any reasonable dataset with uniform quality standards. In summary, the contribution of our work as follows. The first is we produced a standard large-scale dataset of SALR conference papers. This dataset expands the research resource in the field and is available to researchers for extensive research. The second, we propose a well-designed modular hierarchical model for paper quality evaluation. This model takes into account the interaction and aggregation in the hierarchical structure of the paper more fully than existing models, and we are the first to model the guiding zone of the title and abstract. And the second is experimental results on SALR conference dataset show the that our model consistently outperforms the previous strong baseline in three evaluation metrics, quantitative and qualitative, analyzes further validate the superiority of our model. The second part is the related work. Paper quality evaluation is the novel task proposed in 2018. The acceptance of paper in a specific field at a particular level of the conference can be a proxy for quality assessment. The length of a paper is typically thousands of words. Directly using CNN, RNN, or attention on such long texts will be limited by memory and computing power. So researchers generally divide the long texts to build hierarchical next work according to the paper's inherent structure. From word to full text, the structure in aggregation and interaction has three levels, word, sentence, and module. The existing work needs to improve in terms of the position and the contextual information of elements in interaction and elements' importance in aggregation. Besides, these works do not consider the guiding zone of the title and abstract. To address the above two problems in existing work, we propose a well-designed modular hierarchical model. Firstly, we take into account as much possible in the interaction and aggregation process on the hierarchical structure. Second, we are the first to model the guiding zone of the title and abstract. We leverage class attention across the hierarchical structure to generate two full text representation guided by the title or abstract respectively. The second part is our method. We divide each paper into three models, title, abstract, and body. Our proposed model takes the paper text as input and consists of four main components, WtoS encoder, S2P encoder, paper encoder, and the design predictor, as shown in this figure. Note that the part inside the dashed box is the paper encoder. The part below the dashed box is the S2P encoder. The red solid circle represents the multi-dimensional rails to token surface tension module. The following is a detailed description of the module hierarchical model. The W2S encoder aims to capture the relationships between words in a sentence and the importance of each word to the meaning of the sentence. It has been demonstrated that BERT model perform effective knowledge transfer from self-supervised tasks with large-scale training data. The SciBERT is a variant of BERT trained on numerous academic papers. SciBERT contains rich prior knowledge relevant to our task. We tokenize each sentence using vocabulary with a maximum sequence length L following SciBERT. We add CLS at the beginning and SEP at the end of the token sequence of each sentence. If the length of the token sentence is less than L, we append the extra PAD token to the end. Then we feed the words token sequence in each sentence contained in the title, abstract, and body into SciBERT, taking the embedding of the CLS token as the sentence representation. In summary, the W2S encoder lets words in the same sentence interact and aggregates them to get a sentence embedding based on importance scores. The S2P encoder aims to capture the relationships between sentences in a paragraph and the importance of each sentence to the meaning of the paragraph. The input is the sentence embedding of body generated by the W2S encoder. It first generates context-aware embedding for each sentence using the bidirectional self-attention. Based on this context-aware sentence embedding, the multi-dimensional source-to-token self-attention computes attention score. It indicates the importance of each feature of the sentence to the paragraph. This paragraph embedding is a weighted sum of the context-aware sentence representation according to the attention score. We obtain the paragraph embedding after reducing the dimensionality through a full connection layer. This paragraph representation incorporates all the sentence information, the relationship between sentence and the importance after sentence in the paragraph. In summary, the S2P encoder lets sentence in the same paragraph interact and aggregates them to get paragraph embedding based on importance scores. This is the paper encoder. There are two crucial observations there. First, there is an interaction of information among the title, abstract, sentence, and body paragraph. Second, the title guides the abstract's core ideas and core sentence. Similarly, the abstract guides the body's core ideas and core paragraphs. Based on these two observations, the paper encoder is divided into three modules from top to bottom, T class AN, A class AN, and by D3. The T class AN models the titles guiding role for the abstract. This class attention module first calculates the relevance score of the title and the abstract sentence. Then it outputs a weighted sum of the embedding of abstract sentence. The output is the representation of the core abstract guiding by the title. The A class AN module models the abstract guiding role for the body. This class attention module calculates the relevance score between each abstract sentence and each body paragraph. We combine the relevance score for the abstract and the body with the relevance score for the title and the abstract to obtain the final score. The module outputs a weighted sum of the embedding of body paragraphs. This output is the core representation of the core body text guided by the abstract sentence. The more relevant an abstract sentence to the title, the more important it is. The By design module models the interaction of the title, abstract, and body paragraph. Its structure is the same as the S2P encoder. Its input are representation for the title, abstract, sentence, and body paragraph. It It models the relationship with more the title, abstract, and body. In summary, the paper encoder concat the three inputs from the above three modules and four manual feature as output. These four were designed manual features as a number of figures, tables, formulas, and references in the paper. We consider the number of figures and tables to be a rough representation of the paper's experiments. The number of formula partially represents the theoretical correctness of the paper. The number of reference with the author's researches and related work. These manual features are currently tricky for a deep model to learn from the non-textual content. So we combine these four features with the full text representation, which adds richer information. We design a design predictor to finally predict the acceptance of the academic paper, which is a proxy for paper's quality. Specifically, we take the compact representation from the paper encoder as its input. Let it pass through a fully connected layer with the ELU function. This time, its dimensionally is reduced from high dimension to 128. Then we feed it into the fully connected layer with sigmoid function to get the final prediction results. With the existing research on this task, including the work in this paper, is still at a preliminary stage of exploration. We believe that paper quality evaluation will be of great value in the academic field. The third part is experiments and result. We conduct experiments on a six-year paper dataset from the top conference SCLR to verify the validity of our model for predicting the acceptance of papers. Table 1. Table shows the detailed statistics of this dataset. All samples are randomly shuffled before dividing the dataset. We follow a 7:2:1 dimension ratio, meaning that 600, 100 papers are used as the training, validation, and test sets respectively. The experiment's results are shown in table. As we can show, MHM achieves the best performance results in each of the metrics. This demonstrates the effectiveness of our model and its generalizability over the text set. Specifically, NB and LR models have the worst results on the dataset. Among the three deep learning models, we find that the results of text CNN are almost close to LR. Moreover, DP CNN performs significantly better than text CNN, which indicates that CNN with more layer can layer deeper feature and thus perform later. Among the five preferred models, GPT-2 and SciGPT-2 performs poorly. This may be because the generative model are not good at serving non-text classification. Compared to SciBERT, MHM exceeds on AUC, MAFE, and MIFE respectively. This demonstrates the effectiveness of our model on the task of predicting the acceptance of academic papers. In addition, the decision predicted by MHM are currently not entirely correct, but still can be helpful as an aid tool for people. We also perform the following ablation study on MHM to evaluate the contribution of each component. The results are shown in this table. The full version of MHM can outperform wall variance with individual components removed, which indicate that each component is important. Whether the effect of removing the feature is not as significant, it still provides useful information for the model. The model currently has difficulty learning this information from the input text. In conclusion, all these encoders and features are crucial in improving the model's prediction performance. This is our case study. We randomly sample 20 samples and evaluate the attention score to obtain the following findings. Consistent with the idea of human review, it suggests that the model does capture essential information. However, such analyses may miss excellent papers that do not follow in this standard writing style. We then analyzed the top 10 highest rated truly positives. We found that most of them have keywords such as code is available, acknowledgement, appendix, and state of the art. This is another case study. We investigate the error case that our model does not predict correctly on the SCLR dataset and found that results. However, the public available human review comments on open review indicate that this paper is too simple and does not contribute enough. Our analysis of the lowest score for selective finds that the model misidentifies the core sentence in the abstract. The five part is the conclusion. In this paper, we propose a module hierarchical model for paper quality evaluation. We consider fuller interaction and aggregation in the hierarchic than in existing models. We are the first to model the guiding role of titles and abstracts to generate core representation. Experiments results on the large scale dataset we produce shows that our model outperforms the strong baseline model by a large margin on wall evaluation metric. But our model can hardly learn the feature of figures, tables, formulas, and reference without manual features. It also failed to truly understand the contribution and the innovation of the paper. With the development of document image understanding, we plan to investigate the combination of images and texts in papers in the future. better learn more features of papers. We also hope that in subsequent work, the model will be able to better understand and evaluate the paper's innovation and contributions. Thank you for listening. That's all for today's presentation. Does anyone have any questions about my presentation?